Welcome to Critical Thought TV. I'm your host, Stuart Dambrot. Today, we have the inimitable Ben Goertzel with us. Ben is a self-described cosmist and singularitarian. He's also the CEO of Novamente and Biomind, and as well as the chief science officer of Idea Holdings. Among his other affiliations, he's the chairman of the Artificial General Intelligence Society, as well as the OpenCog Foundation. Welcome, and thank you so much for coming.
Thanks for inviting me.
It's really my pleasure, more than I could say. I thought perhaps that since the focus is going to be largely on artificial general intelligence, we'd best start with some terms, concepts in AGI, and perhaps even more importantly, what differentiates AI and AGI. I say that because even amongst practitioners, there's debate. There are some AI practitioners that say AGI is an unnecessary concept and acronym. So I'd like you to address that, because I disagree with that position.
When the field of AI was founded in the late 1950s, it had a pretty ambitious scope. The idea they had then was to create computer programs and robots that could think as well as people, that could do everything that people can, and more. Since that time, the field of AI has broadened a lot. One of the things that has been discovered since those early days is that you can write computer programs doing a lot of pretty intelligent things in a way that has nothing to do with human intelligence, and in a way that's very, very narrowly specialized. So, for example, Deep Blue beat Garry Kasparov, the world chess champion at chess, but Deep Blue doesn't think about chess like people do. It thinks about it in a very narrow, focused way. Deep Blue can only play chess. It can't play any other game. It can't generalize from one domain to another. Since the field of AI has spread out so much to encompass all these very narrowly focused intelligent programs doing things like playing games, driving cars, predicting the stock market, managing the supply chain, controlling military robots, it's become useful to specifically distinguish that part of AI that's really concerned with human-level intelligence or with general intelligence, with thinking like people do it, which is not just tied to one application area, but spans pretty much everything using the same methods. Humans can take something we learned in one domain and transfer it to another domain. We can do this kind of lateral, creative, analogical thinking, which lets us cope with problems that didn't exist when we were born.
More than that, it's also the case that we're driven to do that, which is another thing altogether. We're driven to extrapolate. We're driven to generalize. We're driven to find patterns between distal areas that then lead to something new and creative, like you were saying. So how can you draw, I would say one, then I would ask if that is one differentiation between a true AGI and just, say, an expert system or some of the other examples you were mentioning.
I think there are two points in what you just said. One is that human beings are agents. They're not just problem-solving tools. So a human being controls a body in a world. It has certain goals, which can shift as the human being develops over time. Some of them are built-in goals, wired in by evolution, getting sex, getting food, staying alive. Some of them are goals that we pick up culturally or create ourselves during our lives. But we are agents with certain goals, controlling a body in an environment, and that sets us apart from most of the AI programs out there that are pretty much tools used by some other agent to do something.
Ah, I see.
The other point that you raised has to do with what are the goals of human agents or AGI agents. You could make an agent with a very specific goal, like kill the enemy, win the chess game, you know, find the cure for cancer. On the other hand, you can make an agent with a more general goal, like learn new things, improve yourself, expand your scope of functionality, create new things. When you create an agent with open-ended goals like that, then you're creating something that can develop and go in all sorts of new directions over time. Human beings are agents with pretty open-ended goals alongside the more basic biological goals. AGI systems, if they're really going to flourish up to the human level of intelligence and beyond, I think they need to be agents and they need to have open-ended goal systems. This is both an amazing opportunity and it's a challenge and it's a risk, because once you've created an AI with an open-ended goal system, that AI can develop in all sorts of different directions. It becomes harder to predict and constrain what it's going to do.
Right, which leads to the ongoing debate between should we not create these open-ended AGIs if, in fact, they're not their behavior and their thought processes and their goal setting is not predetermined, and we don't know what it's going to be, therefore we don't know if they're going to look at us as something that is perhaps irrelevant, that whole argument that is put forth by quite a number of players in the space. On the other hand, it could also make the case that because we don't know what level of benefits to human beings can come about because of an emergent AGI. So I'd like to ask you where you fall on this line and how you see it in terms of the line of is it something that, because it's could be unpredictable, is something that needs to be avoided rather than embraced?
Whether or not to create advanced AGI is a very uninteresting question, because it's just going to happen. This is just the next stage in the development of complexity and intelligence and freedom in this corner of the universe. You know, we had the prebiotic soup, we had early stage one-celled life forms, we have multi-celled life forms, we have plants, we have animals, now we have humans that have developed culture and machines, and what's going to happen next is advanced engineered artificial general intelligences. The only thing that is going to stop it, potentially, the only thing that could stop it potentially would be if we blow ourselves up or annihilate ourselves with some other advanced technology. As a thought experiment, imagine what happens if President Obama decides, let's stop all AI development. Well, it doesn't stop the rest of the world, right? That just means that advanced AIs are going to be created in China or somewhere instead.
Analogous to the Bush administration cutting funding for federal investigations into stem cells, for example. It went on elsewhere.
What was interesting there is that it went on in New Jersey and California and various states that funded stem cell research with state funding. So if you look at the history of publications in stem cell research, there wasn't even a period where the U.S. fell behind, because the U.S. central government didn't even manage to impose that mandate.
Right, because it was federal funding only.
If you even take the next step, you can say, what if the U.S. government decided to outlaw AGI research, but allow narrow AI? So the government could say, well, we'll allow AI to kind of help us drive our car and do web search and help us blow up people, but help us predict the stock market, play games, but we're not going to allow an AI to become an AGI, become truly thoughtful and intelligent. Right. The problem becomes, where do you draw the line? Let's say you have a home service robot. Everyone would buy a home service robot if it were available. If you could pay a couple $1,000 and get Rosie the robot to go around and clean up your house and walk your dog, everyone's going to do it. But then everyone wants their home service robot to be smarter and smarter.
Until you get Millennium Man.
Yeah, sure. And if you're using narrow AI, statistical prediction methods to predict the stock market, who wouldn't want a slightly more intelligent thing with a little more general understanding to help them make more money on their portfolio, right?
Right, yeah.
There is a difference between narrow AI and AGI. However, the borderline it's not easy to pin down from a legal point of view, because the AI research community, the AI research community can't even agree on which pieces of narrow AI are going to be critical components of AGI, which pieces of AGI could be generalized into narrow AI. Sorry. Which pieces of narrow AI could be generalized into AGI? So how could the government ever put a dividing line?
Moreover, you would think that, I mean, I may be wrong about this, so I'm asking, but a robust AGI system would have, just like we have low-level non-neocortical but encephalized functionality, you could see that an AGI perhaps would have narrow AGI as, say, embodied, if you will, embodied processes that would be narrowly focused.
I think so.
Yeah.
In my own approach to AGI, which is the open source, OpenCog architecture, we combine a number of different components together in a cognitive architecture. The overall architecture is modeled on human thought, but the individual components that we integrate together, each of these has some functionality on its own as a narrow AI system. For example, we have a component that we call MOSES, which is an acronym for something complicated, Meta-Optimizing Semantic Evolutionary Search. So this component I'm using now to analyze genetics data to try to help figure out why people live a long time. I'm using that component in a stock market analysis project. That component is being used to help a video game character figure out how to build things with blocks. But that same component plays a critical role in OpenCog's attempt to become an artificial general intelligence.
Because it can apply whatever the algorithms MOSES is using, I'm guessing at this, to itself. So it's a reflexive application of its own programmatical state in some ways, which is what we do when we reflect on our own thoughts. In a sense, we're applying how we use thinking to evaluate our own thinking process and look at our own thoughts using thoughts. So that's very interesting.
The point would be, if the U.S. were to outlaw AGI development, but they allowed development only of these components, then someone else can take our components and make an AGI from them, right?
All right. Thank you so much.